consequences in major cities in Tibet. The Tibetans are becoming a minority. And so same thing with Olympic. I think I don't have any grudge against Olympic, but then they're supposed to promote peace and harmony through sports. At the same time, when you give away certain contracts to certain countries, probably the China would be gold mine for that. So this, however, this is not particularly aiming at China. I think who is China? I mean, it's not a border. It is the thought, the principle of the holds. So, but then I have to use the language to so that people can ask me those questions. So, something like that to represent that kind of thinking.
Well, that also the global factor is that God, the globe is melting. Yeah. And one can safely assume that to be global warming, right?
Yeah.
So you're trying to use symbols that will spark not necessarily the universal
emotion. Yeah, so I think this problem's everyone's problem, not just limited within one nation. Aesthetic destruction, meaning that it has more subtlety and more profound imprints on the mind. So that's my intention. But rather than like having people go over there with hammer hitting it, I thought we'd dance and be
Oh,
as much as possible the great traditions of Himalayan art, we also embrace the contemporary art world and artists living today and working today. And Tenzin Rigdol, having been an artist in the missing piece and also having done this essentially performance piece here this afternoon, is one of many artists who have come through these doors to do something very special. And we are opening an exhibition in just 2 weeks' time called Written on the Wind. It's really a series of paintings by artists who were invited, over 100 artists who were invited at the very inception of this museum to come and create a wind horse, a prayer flag of their own, which we then, at the opening of these doors on the 2nd of October 2004, hoisted up to the heights of the museum as a gesture that embraces both the traditional and the contemporary in these walls. And so, Tenzin Rigdol, thank you very much for being such a fundamental part of